radio service stations and dealers from coast to coast present the Fire Chief's Double Quartet. Don Voorhees and the Fire Chief Band. Graham McNamee. And Ed Wynn, the Perfect Fool.
I'm going to be the chief, Graham.
Yeah?
The program is...
Well, it will be different tonight.
Wait and see. Say, Chief, I saw you on a new horse.
What's his name?
Oh, that's the same thing, Graham. The same as you have.
Oh, how'd you ever happen to call a horse Graham?
Well, it's a very strange story, Graham. The horse was born in Kentucky, you know.
Yeah?
Well, of course, that makes him Kentucky bred. You can understand that.
Well, as he is Kentucky bred, and as he sees the black and the white, I thought I'd call him Graham.
That's a good one.
Go ahead.
Seems you certainly love dumb animals, huh?
Oh, I should say I do, Graham. They can't come too dumb for me.
Oh, my goodness.
I'd like to see your collection of animals sometime, Chief. When are you going to invite me out to your house?
Oh, Graham, I didn't want to tell you.
Mm.
I lost my house and everything.
Oh, no.
Yes, I'm living in the park now, you know.
You're living in the park, Chief?
Yes, Graham, I'm living in the park. But I take my meals out.
Goodness.
Well, Steve, speaking of parts, I'm sending my nephew to the zoo.
Is that so, Graham?
Mm-hmm. I'm sending my nephew to Princeton.
Well, don't the police bother you in the park?
Well, Graham, you'd be surprised. The policemen treat me like European royalty.
No.
Really, they treat me just like a king. They kick me out of every place.
Good.
Funny thing happened yesterday, Graham. I lost $15 in the park.
Oh, that's too bad, Chief. How did you come to lose $15?
Well, I didn't lose it all, Graham. You see, I was sitting in a park, and a $10 bill blew out of my hand and fell on the lawn.
Well, that accounts for $10, Chief.
Yeah, well, I'll explain the whole thing, Graham. All You're right. So exacting.
Go ahead. Goodness.
Go ahead. As I was saying, the $10 bill was lost on the lawn. And a policeman fined me $5 for dropping paper on the ground.
Oh, your answers are too much for me, Chief. What's the music?
Well, I'll tell you about the music tonight, Graham. It's kept so damp and chilly in the park, I thought that tonight we'd have that new sneezing song. You know the title of it, Graham?
No, what is it?
The name of it is I Took One Look at You.
I took the music.
Steve, I'm awfully sorry to see you sleeping in the park.
Oh, about sleeping in the park, Graham.
Last night I slept in my uncle's house.
Oh.
That's the same thing, Graham. My uncle keeps pigs in the house, too, you know.
You mean to say he keeps pigs right in the house?
Well, why not, Graham? He has everything in the house a pig could want.
My goodness.
Well, Steve, I'd like to meet your uncle sometime. What kind of a man is he?
Well, he's a very unusual man, Graham. He's very forgetful.
Yeah?
I'll give you an idea of it. Last night at dinner, he tied his spaghetti and ate his shoestring.
Just want to tell you, you know.
How's your uncle's business, Steve?
Oh, his business?
Yeah.
Oh, my uncle must be taking in an awful lot of money, Graham. I heard today that they just appointed a receiver to help him.
Just to help, all right.
What business is he in, Steve?
Well, my uncle is a traveling salesman.
That's the same thing. I thought you knew that, Graham.
No.
He's a traveling salesman for 5 feet 10.
That's all.
Oh, he has the Eastern Territory. But it's a very peculiar thing, Graham.
Yeah?
He's only supposed to sell in the Eastern Territory, you know. But he's got very large feet.
Mm-hmm.
His feet are so big that the salesmen in the Middle West claim he's stepping in their territory.
Do you enjoy living in his home?
Yes, I do, but it's awfully noisy in his house, Graham.
What?
In fact, it's so noisy that every time I write a letter, I unconsciously dated the 4th of July.
Come on, Chief. What's the music?
Now, tonight, I'm thinking of the country, so I thought we'd have the new vegetable song. You'll never get the name of it.
No.
Vegetable song. The title of it is, I Water Collect You Like I Used to Do.
Late tonight.
Oh, well, Graham, this is really strange. I fell asleep on my horse coming down here tonight, Graham.
No.
As a rule, my horse knows all the lights, so I don't worry, you know. But tonight he stopped on one corner for 25 minutes.
He did?
Yes.
Look at that, Graham.
He didn't know he was walking in a drugstore window, you know. As a matter of fact, he was waiting for the red light in the window to change to green, you know. That's a terrible thing. I had to leave him right there and climb up the rest of the hill all by myself.
Yeah. And still you won't buy a car?
No, sir.
Why?
With Texaco Fire Chief, the gasoline originally developed for fire engines,
yeah,
no hill could possibly give you trouble.
Thank
and
you.
Another thing, too. You'll be here on time, Chief. Graham, I don't want to buy an automobile. I was just stopped.
Oh, I can't understand you, Chief.
What do you think of the new tip I say?
Oh, I don't know, Graham. I've never been hit by one of those cars.
Chief.
I don't know what to
do. Well, Chief, someday you'll buy a car and find out for yourself what a powerful gasoline Texaco Fire Chief really is.
That sounds silly to me.
No. I'm using some of that Texaco Fire Chief gasoline in my cigarette lighter, Graham.
Oh,
well, how does it work, Chief? Oh, it works wonderful, Graham. I get about 60 cigarettes to the gallon out of it.
Well, Chief...
Anyway, but I tell you, Chief, you'll get real mileage with Texaco Fire Chief in the tank.
Yeah.
More miles to the gallon. It's a fact. Here's something to remember.
What's that?
Texaco Fire Chief surpasses the United States government specifications for emergency fuel.
Now, that's a fact.
Oh, Graham, I don't want to keep harping on the subject. But of course, just came to me.
Yeah.
This is for not the people listening in, just between us.
Yeah.
What costs the most? Texaco Fire Chief gasoline or Texaco Fire Chief gasoline?
Oh, wait a minute. Are you going to keep asking me just for a dollar?
One little mistake. I just didn't make a mistake, man. I'm not keeping you asking for that. But I just want to know, really, which costs the most? Or does it, is there any extra cost to it at all, Graham? You don't pay 1 cent extra for Texaco Fire Chief.
That's so.
Because it's produced on such a large scale, it can be sold at the same price as ordinary gasoline.
Oh, the gasoline might not be expensive, Graham, but the car itself is very expensive.
I'll give you an idea. My uncle bought a car, and they told him it could get repaired for it in every city. And he does.
Oh.
tonight, the opera is very unusual.
It would be.
We'll never even get over the title. The title of the opera is When You Were 8 and I Was 9 and We Were 17.
Well, it's about a boy and a girl.
Yes, actually. The boy's name is J. Wethersmith Riley. He was born during the World War. And they call him Wethersmith because he kept his father out of the draft.
Will you hear this?
Yeah. I want you to hear that this is the best of any of the operas. The boy, you know, Wethersmith, yeah. The boy had so many wrinkles on his forehead, he had to throw his hat on his head. Well, it seems that he is a country boy, and on his 21st birthday, for a present, his uncle sends him a bathtub. But being a country boy, he has never seen a tub before. So he writes his uncle a letter. He says, thanks for the boat, but you forgot the yours. So, it seems that when old man Riley, that's the boy's father,
yeah.
When old man Riley died, he left his son Wethersmith a large farm and also $1,000. In other words, his entire estate is $1,000. Now, the girl comes to the farm to buy some eggs. That's the girl in the opera.
Mm-hmm.
The girl says, how much are eggs? And the boy says, 60 cents a dozen. And the cut days are 30 cents a dozen. What do you think the girl said?
What's
the
pay?
The girl said, that's fine. Cut me a dozen of the brown ones.
Wait a minute, Glenn.
They go into the hen house for the eggs.
Yeah.
As they enter, they hear a known rooster talking to a chicken.
That's unusual, you know.
The rooster is saying to the chicken, that now listen, chicken, always remember the old saying, a naked day keeps the butcher away. Well, the girl laughs, and the boy says, what is your name? And the girl says, my name is Opium. I was named after my father. And the boy says, Opium? Why, that's a dope. And the girl says, so is my father. Wait a minute. Well, the boy says, may I call you up sometime? And the girl says, yes. My phone number is Aqua 820. And the boy says, ain't too old, that sounds like water. And the girl says, well, I'm living on a houseboat. So, they decide to get married. He takes her to the boat. But it seems that the boat has a big, oh, a terrific leak in it. And they marry on the leaking boat and settle down. Say that. Fucking around the door.
Oh, lovely.
The rooms are so small in their cottage that their dog has to wag its tail up and down instead of sideways. This dog, by the way, happens to be an Einstein pup. No one could explain its relativity. Now, wait a minute. Now, the boy, you see. The boy, Wethersmith. What do you know? Well, Wethersmith, the boy never takes his stride out walking anymore. It seems that he has grown so fat that people accused him of leading a double wife. So, the wife cooked dinner for him. The husband said, what is that you brought here? And she said, that is canvas back duck. And he said, well, take the canvas back and bring me the duck. But the wife brings him a steak instead. And the steak is so tough that he said to his wife, turn on the radio. Maybe someday in this same common, I feel like a bullfighter. No! She's not fine. And the husband rushes over to make up. And the husband kisses her, using the loose lip system. She says, what's the matter, dear? You don't seem to get the same thrill kissing me that you used to. And he says, well, conditions are bad everywhere. Wait a minute, dear. He said, and what for? This I want you to listen to.
Yeah.
He said, what for? I don't like the taste of your lips tonight. And the wife says, well, that's very strange. I'm using the new fruit flavored lipstick. Monday night I used apple flavored lipstick and you liked it. And last night I used the plum lipstick and you said you liked it. And the husband said, I know I did. But tonight I think you gave me the raspberry. Wait a minute. All during these years, you know, he has changed. His hair is now white on the temples. That's from blowing smoke off the solid roof. Anyhow, his wife opens the door, and she peeps in. She says, may I come in? And her husband says, take a leg. There's always room for one board. Well, the wife was singing. She says, I sing just to kill time. And he says, well, I heard you, and you've got a great weapon. Well, this becomes so excited that her blood pressure rises. It rises so high that there's snow on the peak. Well, no! She said to her husband, how you have changed. You told me when we were married you were going in business with me. Oh, just for yourself, that's what you said. And she also said, she said, you have gone in business for yourself. You became a bum. Well, this makes Riley angry. And he said to his wife, he said, stop waving your teeth around and say something.
Wait.
The wife says, I'll say something. Look how stingy you are. You bought me the smallest radio that money could buy. Why, our radio is so small, I can only get Amos. I can't even get Andy.
Wait a minute.
All right. And he says, you were so stingy, look at my clothes. You bought me a fur coat. You told me it was mink, but I know it's cat fur. And he said, how do you know it's cat fur? And she said, I'll tell you how I know it's cat fur. The first day I wore the coat of dog takes me up a tree.
Wait a minute.
Their fight becomes so noisy that a policeman runs into the house. Just as the wife picks up a knife.
Yes,
and he grabs the wife's arm. The policeman takes her husband and says, who are you? The man says, I am Riley. And if the policeman leads the woman away from the house, he says to her, who are you? And she says, I am Riley's wife. His wife.
Thank you.
all gasoline's the same.
Why do you ask that, Pete?
Well, I wondered where they get the red gasoline. So those little red lights on the back of the automobile.
What was that?
No, Chief, all gasolines are not alike.
I see.
No gasoline can make a two-lunger sound like an ape. No gasoline can compensate for poor mechanism. But in the average car, Texaco Fire Chief will give you quicker getaway and more power. That's because Texaco Fire Chief surpasses the United States government specifications for emergency fuel. That's a fact you can't get around.
Oh, speaking of getting around things, Graham, my uncle hit a man with his car yesterday.
Why didn't he go around and see?
Well, that's what I mean, Graham. Wait a minute, will you?
Yeah.
The man was so fat, my uncle didn't drive around and he was afraid he'd run out of gas.
That's another thing, Chief, about fire chief gasoline.
What's that?
It gives you more miles to the gallon. Tell your uncle to drive up to any Texaco service station and fill up with fire chief gasoline.
Okay.
Then check his mileage against any other gasoline he's ever used.
I'll do that.
And by the way, your uncle could ask about Texaco crack-proof motor oil.
What's that?
He'll hear plenty about this golden oil, the ideal running mate, the Texaco fire chief gasoline.
I'll tell him, Glenn.
Thank you.